I said, I made a mistake, I thought. And then nothing happened for 30 seconds, and it was the longest 30 seconds of my life.
How did you view Enzo Ferrari at that time?
He was, for me, the most charismatic guy I've ever met in my life. Why? Because he was a very tough cookie, very tough, hard, demanding man for his team, for his car, and for himself. But he was an Italian with a big heart. So it was always this combination with him. If he respected you, and in the end he did respect me, he was hard with me for, like everybody else, but at the same time I knew that he liked you. And when you had this relationship, he was fantastic to work with him. And in Salzburg, my cousin had a little office with a secretary, and I used the secretary if I had to write some letters. And I always had this joke there to say, when Ferrari calls, call me right away. This was the ongoing joke for 2 years. I came home on Monday afternoon, and the girl said, Ferrari called. What? Ferrari called, here's the number. And then I came to see Ferrari, Mr. Ferrari. He said, doing a good job. He drove in front of my car in Monte Carlo. I want to sign you up. To sign me up, okay.
What did you say?
I said, Mr. Commentatore, I have a little problem. Because I have agreed yesterday with Louis Stanley that I will continue to drive for BRM. I told him straightforward all my sponsorship problems. The old man looked at his guy Gozzi, who was his second man. We sort these things out, he said. How are you going to sort these things out? We're going to sort it out. Sign here. So I said again, you're going to sort it out. You know, I have a contract. Here's an option that I continue. Don't worry, we're going to sort this out. We have lawyers in England. We can do all that.
What were your impressions of the car, the Ferrari car, the first time you drove it?
I drove it in, sorry, in 73 it was. I drove it in 73 after the season was stopped, the first time in Fiorano with a Ferrari. Piero Ferrari's son was there as an interpreter because I couldn't speak Italian. And the old man said to Piero, ask him how the car is. And I said, the car is understeers like hell, doesn't work in my normal, straightforward language. And Piero said, you can't say the car is why? It is I said in English. The old man was listening. And I can't say this to my father. And I tell him. The car is no good, tell him no good, if this is a better word.
But this is Ferrari.
Ferrari standing there. And then Piero said to him, Niki said the car is no good. This little bit I understood. And then the old man said, what did he say? A Ferrari is no good? Yes, it's shit, I said even then, to him direct. And then I tell you, I said shit, I made a mistake, I thought. And then nothing happened for 30 seconds, and it was the longest 30 seconds of my life. And then he said, okay, what is shit? It understeers. Front end is wrong, doesn't turn in. The BRM I drove was a perfect handling car, turned in, quick out, quick in. Engine was no good, but this was a good car. This is not a good car. So then he said, okay. Fogheri, who was the engineer in charge of the at the time, come here. If Fogheri fixed this car and he has to fix the car, how much can he go quicker if the understeer is gone? I said, 3/10, maybe 5 in Fiorano.
Of a second.
Yeah. So the old man said, fine.
And that amount of time means everything in racing?
If you don't go 5/10 quicker, you're fired. Why? Because you say the car is you say if you fix it, you can go 5/10 quicker. But if you cannot deliver what you ask me to do, then you have a problem. Goodbye. Took Fogheri 5 days to fix this front suspension. It was completely wrong. We did the first test, we were 8/10 quicker. So then my relationship with Fogheri worked out perfect. Ferrari was happy that I fulfilled my obligations. And I tell you, this was the first time where I saw after we delivered that he respected me. And I think this was very important. And from then on, I had a very good time with him.
What transpired the time you were with Ferrari during contract negotiations?
He paid me no money at all because I was happy to drive a Ferrari. So I did a very good job in the first year. I won a couple of races and I was really getting up to the top. And then he wanted to give me a longer contract. And then I was looking around who gets which money of the other drivers in England. And Ronnie Peterson at the time was the highest paid driver going to Lotus. And then I knew that he was getting $250,000, $300,000 per year. And this was the number I had in my head. And as I had zero before, then he said, no, let's make a new contract. And quante vuoi per guidare per me? What do you want? And I said, $3 million was the right way. And he said, okay. Then he picked up the phone, called his accountant de la casa, and he says, quanti in lire 3 milioni di scellini? How much in lire is 3 million shillings? The guy told him the number. What? Put the phone out, screamed at me like he did not believe. How can you ask this amount of money? It is a Ferrari. In a Ferrari, you have to be happy to drive a Ferrari. You know, fine, it's a Ferrari, but you still need a driver to move your car around quick. So I said, I want 3 million, that's it. And he looked at me, called De La Casa again, tried to argue forward and backwards a little bit up and down. He said, no, please pay because the other get the same amount of money. It's not unfair what I'm asking you. Ask the English guys what they get. In the end, he paid me. Yeah, and then he was happy anyway after because we won the world championship.